Amner Hunter here from AmnerHunter.com. Happy to spend some time with you in another video. This time around, we are going to be checking out the different updates of the latest version of the RipX Deep Remix software and application for Windows and Mac by the company Hit and Mix. In this video, I want to walk you through some of the latest improvements and how you can apply it and use it in your own music productions, or also to basically analyze songs, remix songs, practice also your favorite songs. This is a super powerful tool to separate instruments from a song and also manipulate all of these different sounds, stems. I have a video that I released some months ago about this app, but now I want to talk about the updates. There is a 21-day free trial available. I am gonna leave the link here in the video description and the first comment. Full disclosure, the company Hit and Mix approached me and contacted me to create this video for you guys and inform you about these updates, but all of the thoughts and opinions remain fully and objectively mine. The company doesn't have any saying on my opinion about this software. Before we begin with the content, let me invite you quickly to my website, AmnerHunter.com, where I have some freebies for you, such as some free PDF guides and ebooks for music producers and guitar players. Also some free tools, such as some collections of guitar impulses, some collections of drum sample packs, among other utilities. And finally, don't forget to check out this channel or my blog, which I am updating almost every day with content like this. So let's get to it. So I am importing here a couple of tracks. One thing that I noticed is that it's very quick to import in this new version. At least it's like 2 times faster than previous versions. So that's one improvement right there. Here it lets you know the amount of time you need to wait to import these tracks. Of course, it depends on the length of the tracks, but I remember in the previous version, it took me a bit more time to get these files done. That's one major improvement right there. Less time and optimization in that sense. It's very important that you select your audio interface and that you connect it to the software in case that you want to record any ideas over the backing tracks, because it's super cool that you don't need another software to record or to practice. You can do it right here. You also need to select your inputs, right? So in this case, I want to record my voice. I want to make it sound like a bass. For instance, you can transform any audio signal into different sounds, and it does it in a very simple way. It's pretty impressive. Let me show you. So I have this track here. It's a simple guitar lead. I am going to record here with my voice. Like I said, I have selected here the audio box USB. So I am gonna add a bass track here, right? I already added. I'm going to press record here. You can mute other tracks. It also has a metronome based on this tempo. So if I put record here, right, so let me undo that. Dun, 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 dun. I'm gonna record that just for the sake of demonstrating that. Dun, 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 dun. Dun, 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 dun. Not the best vocal performance, of course, but we can also correct the pitch of this vocal track. Let's say quantize to pitch, flatten the pitch, and you see it changing here in real time. Dun, dun, dun. So for instance here, if we go to sounds and guitars, here we have bass, and we can use that fader. Let's solo the bass here. Dun, 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 dun. So So let's play it with the guitar just for the sake of it. We can go ahead and pinpoint each of the individual notes, and we can do all sorts of corrections here. So pretty cool, that thing of transforming sounds. Let's go to the guitar. For instance, we can transform also this guitar sound into other guitar sound. Let's check out here, sounds, guitar. For instance, we have a Stratocaster, which, by the way, I recorded with a Jackson guitar. Let's do it here. Let's put here acoustic. Also, one thing that you can do using the same concept is replace entire instrument sections, right? So I'm in this other track here. This is the track. If you use the control in your computer to select a couple of instruments, you can manipulate them at the same time, both of them. So I have this guitar and piano track selected. So let's say if I would want to replace these instruments with, let's say here, classic instruments, for instance, cellos, clarinet, distorted guitar, let's say a cello. So we put it here 100%. Let's listen. Let's unsolo this. So for instance, let's choose a saxophone here, alto sax for instance. Let's take a listen to them in solo. Let's check it out in context. Also, one thing to notice is that the software, whenever you have guitars and stuff like that, you can get also the chords. So if you notice here, you have every four bars, which is in 4-4, you have the chords here, and also this diagram where you can actually see the notes being played on the guitar. Let's go back here to guitar sound, right? Straight guitar sound. Let's listen to it. A5. It's super, super cool to have this for practicing when you're practicing like your favorite cover songs or something. Now you can get like the actual chords. So it's also a very cool learning tool. Also, one cool thing in this new version is the combo effects. You can put together different effects, different presets all together and process any given audio signal. You can do it in like in real time. So for instance, I have this vocal track here. Snow starts falling. Let's say I want to have this vocal track with more delay, with more reverb, and also add some harmonies. For instance, here in the presets section, I have the harmony plus combo that involves some harmonies, shift format, stereo panning, flatten pitch. I can go ahead and put a delay, drag it to the harmony plus combo, and also reverb. Right, so everything is now here, and I can now go ahead and add all of this stuff at once. And also, you're gonna see here the automation lane, which you can draw, by the way, to your liking with your mouse. Super, super cool. Also, another improvement. Let's, for instance, check out the vocal track and let's start to add this combo effect.
Snow starts falling, cracked and frozen, winter too. Snow starts falling, cracked and frozen.
Right, super, super cool, I think. Also, this combo effects, you can do it in many, many different ways. You can combine, like, for instance, here in the times section, you can combine this with reverse effect. And this is a combo now, right? Pretty cool. You can assign these combo effects to particular notes of the instrument. So, for instance, again, in this vocal track,
snow starts falling.
I can assign only effects to that. Let's go ahead here and create a pretty cool effect only in that vocal part. Let's say a delay with a reverse effect. And let's add a bit more delay. Okay, and now let's blend it with the effect. Let's check it out here, the whole performance.
There.
Right, let's go back again.
Snow starts falling.
Pretty cool, right? Only in this section of the vocal. And you can always go back and delete this combo effect here. Right click and remove, and that's pretty much it. Super powerful tool, of course, to remix a song. Here, for instance, these controls, these faders, let's say, it's very simple to remix a song, changing balances and volumes. So, for instance, let's have this track. Right? Let's say I want more bass. Less bass.
Snow starts falling, crowded.
Yeah, it does it in a very, very simple way. All you need to do is just be familiar with the interface, but I think it's a super, super powerful tool for all things related to stem separation, also manipulation of already mixed tracks, and also the features with the combo effects, the recording integrated, the transforming of sound. It makes it a super, super valuable and helpful tool for musicians, music producers, all around audio enthusiasts as well. Also to analyze your favorite songs, right? Super, super cool to be able to have these tools at our disposal. Please let me know what you think of this app by Hidden Mix. What do you think of these updates? I am very interested to know your opinion. Also, how would you use it? How can you use it? How can you apply it in your music productions? Remember that there is a free trial, so go ahead and check it out. The link is in the video description. Let me invite you one last time to my website, where I have some additional freebies, such as some free PDF guides and ebooks for music producers and guitar players. Also some free tools, such as some collections of guitar impulses, some collections of drum sample packs, among other utilities. And finally, don't forget to check out my channel or my blog, which I am updating almost every day with content like this. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate it very much. I will see you very soon in the next one.